In Jesus' name.
Amen.
So you're going to declare yourself. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let every evil ladder
place
before
me.
Disgrace me. Turn to ladder of honor. Begin to declare. Shake off Jesus Christ, Holy Mighty. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil ladder place before me to disgrace me. Let them turn to ladder of honor. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil ladder, place to disgrace me, place to harass me. Every evil ladder, place before me to disgrace me, to harass me. Let them come to ladder of honor in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them come to ladder of honor in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we are praying. I stand on that rock of ages and I soak myself in the blood of Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
And I declare, every evil ladder placed before you to harass you, to disgrace you, is going to turn to ladder of honor in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
They gather against you to mock you. They gather against you to explain that bad news. But in the mighty name of Jesus, they are going to hear your testimony.
Yeah.
They believe they are fleeing their agenda. They know whatever they put, no problem, it's going to work. But in the mighty name of Jesus, massive is giving their portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
For in Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen,
amen, amen, amen in Jesus' name. Say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, let my virtues, my joy, my progress in the satanic valley begin to come up by fire in the name of Jesus. Say, my virtues, my joy, my progress, my victory, oh, my success, that I'm in satanic valley, begin to come up by fire, begin to declare, Jehovah, Jesus Christ, Holy Mighty, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, let my virtues, my success, my breakthrough, my victory, my joy, in the Holy Valley, let them come out with fire, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them come out with fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them come out with fire in the name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
I decree and I declare your virtues, your joy, your breakthrough, your success, your victory, that I in the demonic valley that are going to come up by fire right now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I stand on that rock of ages and I soak myself in the blood of Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
All your passions, all your success, all your joy, all your victory, all your breakthrough that are in the demonic valley, they are going to come out right now by fire in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
And you are moving to the next level.
Yeah.
You are moving to the next level.
Yeah.
You are moving to the next level.
Yeah.
For in Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power that is wrestling or contesting my victory. Every power that is wrestling or contesting my victory. Or my breakthrough. Let them die in the name of Jesus. Let them die right now. Let them die in the name of Jesus. Begin to declare, Jehovah, Jesus Christ, Holy Mighty. Father, in your infinite power, let every power, Lord, every power, resting or contesting my victory with me, contesting my joy with me, contesting my blessing with me, let them die now in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them die now in the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I decree and I declare in the mighty name of Jesus, every power resting within your joy. Every power contesting your breakthrough with you, every power contesting your victory with you, they are going to die right now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The fire of the Lord will consume them right now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Let us pray for this church before we sit down. Pray then. Say every power.
Every power.
Every power.
Every power.
Contesting the victory of this church.
Contesting
the victory of this church. For any success of this job, let them die right now.
in your infinite power. Every power, every human being, contesting the victory, contesting the success, the joy of this church, the joy of celestial church of Christ, find Paris UK, a place that pain is being released and success for it. Let them die now in the mighty name of Jesus. They must die for you and let them swear them in Jesus' name. For in Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
For in Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
I stand on that rock of faith and I soak myself in the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
And I stand on the promise of the Lord. Whatever I declare that come to pass,
amen.
Every power concerning the victory of this church, concerning the success of this church, they are going to die now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
They are going to die right now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, for your answer and prayer. For Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
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 Let us be seated. Once again, I welcome to celebrate the surprise. Vine Parish UK. The place where pain is being relieved and success polished. I pray the mighty name of Jesus. Any pain in your life will relieve in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And the success of your life will polish in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This one I'll be speaking briefly about the topic. I said, be patient and don't go naked. Be patient and don't go naked. Some people, because they have no patience, they went naked. And they opened the door for enemies to attack them. The lesson read for us this morning, that the first lesson, that is the book of Exodus, chapter 32, from verse 26. The Israelites, they were not patient enough. And they went naked, and they were prone to attack. Thanks for the glory of God that shined quickly, they were going in trouble. These Israelites, they've been experiencing the joy and favor of the Lord. But the joy and the favor that they've been experiencing, just in a twinkle of an eye, they forget everything. They could not realize it again. God, in His infinite power, took them away from the Egypt. God, in His infinite power, parted the Red Sea for them. He was feeding them. He was guiding them. But Moses was not available for a while, and alas, they needed a physical God. And this made them to be naked. And they were prone to attack. But thank God for Jesus. Thank God for Moses to be alive, to be around to rescue them. The Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And don't even read that book of Exodus, chapter 22. Can you read verse 23 for me, please, man? For they said unto me, let me let's start from 22, because this is what we're going to start. And they don't say, let not thy anger. Elon said, let not the anger of the Lord wash off. Can you read for me, please?
Exodus
32. Exodus 32. 32 from verse 22.
22.
Yes.
And Elon said,
yes.
Let not the anger of my Lord wash off. Thou knowest the people that they are set on mischief.
Amen.
Amen.
He said, thou knowest the people that are set on mischief. Continue, man.
23.
Yeah.
For they said unto me, make us gods, we shall go before us. For as for this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we work not what is become of him.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, sit down with him. He said, no, what becomes of him. May the Lord forgive us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brethren, you know that Moses was not available for a while. Moses rescued his people from the land of Egypt, where they were as a slave. They were there as a slave, suffering. And Moses rescued them. But alas, for a second, they did not see Moses. They said, we don't know what become of him. Make us another God. Some of us today, we are like that. We forget where we are coming from. We do not think what God has been doing in our life. The great thing God has been doing for us, we forget quickly. The moment we are not where we desire to be, we change our mind. The moment we will forget, we quickly forget. This morning you will ask them to sleep safely, and this morning you don't wake up safely. You think they are this alarm that wake you up? Oh, she mistake. A lot of people set up the same alarm, and today they are no more. That only is enough for you to glorify God. And most of all, we have got a lot of victory. We got married, we have children, we have a job, you know. But alas, because something is not satisfying you, and because you don't know, you are where you needed to be, not where you want to be. Most of all, don't forget that particular something. Some of us are where we need to be, not where we need to be. Not where we want to be. God may want to keep you for a while at the particular spot, so that you are not going to miss your time, or so that you may be trained to be able to enjoy your success when it comes. So that you can manage that which you will eventually get it. But because you are in a hurry, you forget that God is still working in your life and begin to seek for another God. And how do we do it? Instead of you seeing the way you worship God and God is answering your prayer, begin to go on prophet. Like as Israelite went to Aaron to complain to Aaron. Say, listen, we don't know what has become this man, this Moses that led us out of their brothers up here from Egypt. We don't know what has become of him. Please find us a God. That is human being for you. You will say, I don't know. You see, I've been let's say now for 20 years. I've been here for 10 years. See my friend, I just bought a house. I don't even have a house. See the children of my friend, they are now getting married. See this one. You begin to complain. You lamented, you forgotten how God brought you from Nigeria to UK, number one. He brought you here, he established you, number two. That you are even alive. I was telling you that I was saying, look, some say, I don't know. I have been praying. I don't even have my papers. We don't have a pass. We put a house in Nigeria. We don't have a pass. You have children. We don't have a pass. You have good health. But because you don't have that paper, you cannot glorify God. What you are doing is that you are looking for another God. You are calling this prophet. Hello, daddy. I've not got this paper. I've not gotten it. And you call another prophet. Hey, this is a prophet. Every in the mobile, it's your face I'm looking at now. Is this paper? You call another prophet. And people you are talking to, they will take you to a place you don't like. They will take you to a palace. They will now tell you, I know somebody. This person is very hot. Oh, go now. You are going to put this sacrifice. They will not take you away from God, and that will destroy you. That's not the apostle in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This is what the Israelites did. They told Aaron, we don't know what has come on Moses that brought us here. Now continue, man.
24. And I said unto them, whosoever hath any gold, let them break it off.
Amen. With them. And all of this prophet, all of this fair prophet, fair pastor, fair shepherd, fair apostle, fair mother, a mother in Celestia, a mother in Israel, for them to advise you that look, there's nothing God cannot do. Hold up, please, the new one. Your joy is coming. Your joy is coming. They begin to mislead you. Don't mind that man who called him. Why is he? Who made him a prophet? Who made him a shepherd? He said, I see there. Let me take you somewhere where they can really pray your prayer will be answered. They will not mislead you. They will take you to a useless place. Aaron said, Aaron to advise the Israelite that look, Moses is coming. Let's go down the room. Hold your place. And let's see what God will do. He said, you have go there. They made another God for them. I pray the mighty name of Jesus. They are not going to belong to Jesus. Let another man is a garment in Jesus' name.
They
are not going to belong to wolves. To wolves in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
He's not going to advise you that please no. Remain a little bit of time. Take care as they begin to give you some useless advice. We are going to let's go to Dorsey. They go and buy one of people, they go and buy one more for you. They begin to do something, they say they are doing work for you. They will not enter an evil covenant. The Lord forgive us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You not get, at the end of the day, get everybody that you are not going to solve it, you are not going to make any success out of it. That will be a question in Jesus' name.
Amen.
They don't do not advise them anywhere. He gave them a wrong advice. Continue, man.
So they gave it in, and I cast it into the fire, and there came out this calf. And when Moses saw that the people were naked, for Aaron had made them naked unto their shame among their enemies, then Moses stood in the gate of the camp.
Amen. Remember. Let us rise up and pray this prayer. Please rise up and pray this prayer. Rise up. Say, in the mighty name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
I'm not going to take a step that will destroy me. I'm not going to take a step that I'm going to make me point to the enemies. I'm not going to take a step that I'm going to make me naked. Begin to declare, Jehovah, Jesus Christ, Holy Michael, in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm not going to take a step that will destroy me. I'm not going to take a step that will make me naked. I'm not going to take a step that will make me to my enemies. For in Jesus' name we are praying. Let us sit down. I decree in the mighty name of Jesus, we are not going to take a set that will destroy you.
Amen.
A set that will open up for the enemies, we are not going to take it.
Amen.
Now, when was he saw this? Read that 25 verse again.
Amen.
They could not be patient enough because Moses was. went to Sodom was wanted for just for a few hours. They said, you know what I'll become of you. Continue.
26.
Yes, ma'am.
And Moses stood in the gates of the camp.
Now listen, this was what I bought from this morning. When I was sent, when I met inside this morning, me and my wife got a lot of idea about this particular verse. Continue, ma'am.
And said, who is on the Lord's side? Let him come unto me. And all the sons of the Levi gathered themselves together unto him.
Amen.
Amen.
The moment they made that calf, they are no more on the God's side. And that went into Dominican. The moment you are on you are out of the shadow of the Almighty, you are naked. The moment you are not under his shadow, what you finish, that's not their portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So Moses could see that even they are naked, he now stood aside. He now said, if you are on the Lord's side, come over here. In other words, if you are not careful, you can still be on the Lord's side and still be naked by your actions and reactions. He said, because the Levites are among them. So the those are left side and Lord side did not move on to Moses. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Continually, you're going to be on the Lord's side in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brethren, this morning, I want to beg us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us begin to think deeply before we take any step. Catch your blessing. Oh. You see, the enemies are so smart. They begin to paint what is not for you. And you cannot relax enough to take the wrong step. You may not be where you ought to be right now, but if you are a child of God, I can assure you, you are where you need to be. I've shared a lot of testimony. Let me just share one with you quickly. I was looking for a job for like 10 years, and at the end of them, I got it, and they took it away from me. They took this job away from me. I was mad, I was crazy, I was down. But thank God for Jesus. As a born again Christian, I knelt down and I thank God. Today, I thank God I don't go for that job. No, you will not make me a bash again. Today, I will not bash again, not the one who will buy the one. I pray for this job for 10 good years. I was working hard for this job. I'm going to encourage us. I want to hear your testimony. You tell me your testimony, I will tell you my testimony. We can share together to know how big our God is. So that we can encourage ourselves. Because you see, when you have experienced God, you become a soldier for Christ. When you have testimonies about, I will share one with my wife this morning. I said, dear, remember so and so. This man, I was paying, I rented a house. I was paying for the rentage or for the electric of that house for like 5 years. I have a list of challenges. I was paying 500 naira for the rentage of that shop. I had these challenges, this man increased to times three, to 1,500. I was paying 600 to 1,800. From 600 to 1,800, because I had the challenges. But he never knew when I begin to answer my prayer. He's not going to invite a lawyer that can sign. And I said, I'm going to borrow money from my uncles. Go and bring the agreement. Do not bring the agreement. I paid this money. I paid my contribution. Later, I left that place. You know what he did? He went and got a fake receipt of what I had and arrested me for stealing. But luckily, I did that thing for, I did about 5 years ago, and I paid £300 for it, £300 for it. And he got a list of 7,000. He got a current value. So when we get to the police, when they are investigating this case, they came out. So he has given a testament that we did this, that the one that made the burglary for 7,000. I have given a testament that made this burglary for 250 naira. So when that man bring a value to value it, that if this same cost for a month this now, how much was it cost 10 years ago? The man said 250 naira. The policeman said, the dude said, no, we don't know who did the burglary and who stole it. Immediately, the table turned. He would have gone to jail. They begin to beg me. If I said it, start the case to court, that man says, oh, you want to go to jail. But God said, I'll fought for you. Don't withdraw the case. And I withdrew the case. Achilles, so let me.
Amen.
They think they are offending the agenda, but they will disgrace.
Amen.
I don't want to test.